I want to say here that as Muslims leaders, we have a serious and a fundamental obligation to preach tolerance, coexistence between people of all faith in our country. That today we cannot walk freely in our own country as Muslims. That today our sisters' mode of dress has become a security risk. That when we see our sisters in hijab, the rest of the Kenyan community look at it in a different angle. When the hijab is an Islamic dress, that when our boys wear the kanzu. So I think, starting from this conference, the Muslim religious leaders, the Muslim political leaders, we can no longer hide and bury our heads in the sand. Muslim religious leaders, Muslim political leaders, Muslim professionals, we must come out clearly and stand in a broad daylight and tell the country what Islam stands for.
I think it's important that a meeting like this one can bring out clearly what coexistence means in Islam. And I think it's important for our youth in particular. Because there are so many common issues that bind us, particularly the Muslims and the Christians. If you go and look at the basics of the faith. And I think, therefore, it's important that also this meeting clears the thinking that some of the stereotypes talk about. But the second thing that I also want to, the other thing that I want to conclude with very briefly, because and I don't want to take more time, is that this perception is widespread in the world today. The friction that you see between the West and Islam, that is based on fear-mongering, that is based on exaggeration, misinformation about Islam, that Islam is responsible for all these, you know, wars that are there in the world. Islam is responsible for the terrorism. Islam is responsible for all the, you know, evils. This perception is the one that is really being, you know, taken around all over this world, the wrong information that the scholar has talked about. And this is not what Islam is all about. A very negative perception about non-Muslims that we read about, that we see now you're being profiled in the media, that you must kill non-Muslims, that you must do this, that you must. Yet the faith, the religion is very clear that the Prophet, none other than the Prophet, is being asked, and we're being told, is sent to the whole of mankind as a mercy. You cannot be asked to be merciful to people. At the same time, you can stand here as a preacher, and then our preachers stand up at sometimes, say that, you know, you cannot sit with these people. You must kill non-Muslims. You must do this. And it's clear that, therefore, what you are hearing, what you see sometimes out there, is not what the true Islam stands for.